Hi everyone, welcome to the sixth video on how to use NetConf protocol inside Python script for interacting with networking devices. In this video, we'll see how to get usernames configured in the device, how to add a new user, how to get route details, and how to add new routes. In the previous videos, we have seen how to get capabilities. I'll just quickly run through those scripts. If you execute this, we get the netconf capability supported in the router as a response. And here, if you execute this get schema code, this gives schema of any IETF data model it supports. Here you can see I was getting IETF hyphen interfaces data model schema. So you can see here this is coming from the device, and to get the complete configuration, this was a script which we used. You can see here the complete configuration came as an XML file. I'll copy this and I'll put it in online tool. Actually, this formatting you can do it in Python script itself, but here I was writing bare minimum code to get the configuration. There are libraries like Elementary or Minidom to format it properly inside script itself. We'll go to those details in the upcoming videos. Now we will use online tool itself for formatted. And to filter the hostname, I was using this script. What it does, from the running configuration, it was filtering hostname alone. So I was using a filter here, and here you can see the operation was get config, and from running config I was applying this filter. Let me execute it. You can see I have received the hostname of the device. Similar way, to get an interface configuration, this was a script I used. To get any interface configuration, you just need to give this filter. Once we execute, we'll get the interface configuration. Similar way, to send particular configuration, we used this script. So this configures hostname. You can see here, earlier it was filter here, now it became config. And here you can see the operation, it is edit configuration, and target is running config. If you push this configuration, it will change the hostname to test1234. Similar way, this was a script which we used to use for configuring a device, Gigabit 2 with IP address 22.2. In this video, we'll see how to get the username and add user first. So to get username, we'll use same script. We'll duplicate this script. I'll give a name 08 underscore filter username. Now here, only thing what we need to change is username, because if you see this XML, hostname was coming under native. Similar way, even username comes under native. So we'll try replacing it. Okay, let me execute it. Yeah, you can see here I have one user called admin. We'll verify that here as well. I have one user called admin here. Similar way, how to configure a new user. So for that, I'll duplicate the configure hostname script. I'll call this configure username. And here, this was configuring hostname, so we need to replace this with user config. So we'll see what should be the config. Here you can see one user's configuration. We will copy this. And let me paste it here. Now if you want to format it properly, we'll copy this complete configuration. Put it here, format. This will format XML data. Spacing will not affect XML, but still to see the exact structure, we do this format. Okay. Now we will edit the configuration. I'll create a user called netconf_test, privilege 15, password I'll give unencrypted. And I'll give a password password123. Okay, let's execute this script. Here you can see I have received RPC reply okay. That means configuration is successful. So now let's verify the config. Yeah, you can see here it is configured under the user netconf_test. Now we will see how to get the route details. For that I'll duplicate this filter username. I'll give this 10, get route. Yeah, okay. Now we will verify where is the route details in the XML file. So we'll go to the complete running configuration output. You can see here under native IP and below IP route and IP route interface forward list. You can see there is only one route here, it is 10.10.10. We'll verify that in the device. You can see here I have only one route. So let's create a filter here. So it will be under native, it is going to be IP, and below IP it is going to be route. And inside that it is IP route interface forwarding list. Okay, let's try executing it. You can see I have received the route details. Now if you want to format it, copy this, put it here, format, and this comes in a structured way, XML. If you paste it and execute, we'll get same out. Now I'll save it. Now let's see how to configure a route. I'll duplicate this and I'll call this add route. Sorry, here I need to add the script which does configuration, so I'll copy this script and I'll put it in the add route script. So here we'll see how to configure route. First we'll get the config from here. Yeah, this was the format. I'll copy this. Then this will be under IP. Yeah, route and new route I'll add. I'll give subnet 20 and I'll give destination also same. Let's format it properly. Yeah, now let's execute the script. You can see I have received RPC OK. Now let's verify the route config here. You can see the new route which we added now. I hope this video was helpful. In the upcoming videos, we'll see how to delete a route, how to delete a username, how to save the configuration, how to save output in an XML file, all these details. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.